Hi, this is Anne with SVG Cut File, and today I'm going to show you how to add a monogram to a monogram frame with two files in Cricut Design Space. So the first file will be the monogram alphabet, and the second file will be the monogram frame. All right, let's get started. All right, now I've downloaded my files into my downloads folder. If you're on a PC, your downloads are probably going to be on the left side over here. So to get to that folder, you can find it over in your favorites on the left. So I've downloaded all the files from Etsy. I've got a DXF, a PNG, an SVG, and a zip file. Now these three files are all the same thing, they're just different formats. And these are okay as is, but the zip file needs to be extracted. So to do that on a Mac, you just double click it. To do it on a PC, you'll right click and then choose Extract All or Extract Files. When you do that, it'll create a little folder. And when we open that folder, we can see another SVG, PNG, and DXF. Okay, so that's all the files we need right now. Let's go to Cricut. So I'm opening Cricut Design Space, and then I'll start a new project. I'm going to make my window a little bit bigger. Now I'm going to upload the alphabet file. So I'll choose Upload, Upload Image, and then I'll browse for the file. I'll get into my Downloads folder. If you're on a Mac, you can just hit Option Command L and it'll go straight to your downloads folder. On a PC, hopefully it'll be over here in your favorites. So in my monogram font folder, I'm going to choose the one that ends in SVG. Since we're using Cricut, we'll want the SVG files. If you're using Cameo, you might have to use the DXF file. Okay, so let's choose that SVG file. And these are all bundled on one page, which is fine. Next, we'll hit Save. Then I'm going to click on that and insert images. And here are all the letters. Now the first thing I'm going to do is ungroup everything. So I'll just come over here on the right side under layers and choose ungroup. And the letters I want to use are MAB. So first I'm going to isolate just those three letters. So I'll click on each one and hold shift. And then I'm going to hit Command X or Control X on a PC, and that will cut them. Now we can hit Command A, which is Select All. This is Control A on a PC and delete. And then Command V or Control V on a PC to paste. So now we have just the M, A, and B. Right now we see 9 letters and I only need 3. So I'm going to click on each one and ungroup it. And now I'm going to go through that same process. I'm going to click the ones I want. I want the left side M. I'll hold shift and click the middle A, and then hold shift and click the right B. I'm going to Command X, select all with Command A, delete, and paste with Control V or Command V. Now I can move these up next to each other so that they're in a circular format. Now I want these to always move together. Let's zoom in a little bit. I'll come down here to the lower left corner and choose a plus. I'm just going to drag this until it looks really nice. Okay, now I'm going to draw a box around all three to select all three at the same time, and then we'll group those. This means if we resize or move them, everything will move together as one piece. So we have our monogram ready to go. Now we just need the monogram frame. So we'll come back over here to upload. Come back to upload image, browse again, go back to our downloads, and then just navigate to that other SVG file. And we'll open it. We'll save it. Then we'll click on it and insert it. Okay, now this one is really big, so I'm going to move it up a little bit just by clicking and dragging. I'm going to make sure I have it clicked and then click on the lower right arrows to resize. Okay, we'll make it about the same size as the other one. And you can use the grid lines to match the size of the other one. So we can see we're a little bit below that line, and same here. And we're right down here on this line at the bottom and pretty much the same here. Okay, so now we can ungroup this one. Click the monogram here and delete it. And now we'll click our group and just slide it right in there. Now I'm going to select all, Command A to select the whole thing, and then group it together. Now, we can position it up here near the edges to see how big it's going to be. Right now we're looking at about 2 3/4 inches. So let's say we wanted this to be about 3. Can put it right there. And then to get design space to see it as one piece, we can come over here to the bottom right and weld it. And the next step is to make it. You'll choose your material size here and then just go down here to continue. Connect your Explorer. I don't have mine connected now, but just follow the prompts and you'll be good to go. And that is all you need to do. All right, that's my video for this week. If you liked it, please click on the like button. We also have a Cricut and Cameo Crafters Facebook group. So if you're having any trouble at all, you can join that Facebook group and ask us any questions you need to. And I'll put that link in the description. See you next week.